नमस्ते फ्रेंड्स, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टॉक टू यू अबाउट लाइव एक्सेल। इट इज़ नोन एज लाइव एक्सेल बिकॉज मोशन फ्रॉम इंजन इज ट्रांसफर टू दिस एक्सेल। द अदर एक्सेल वेयर मोशन इज नॉट ट्रांसफर्ड इज नोन एज डेड एक्सेल। इन सम व्हीकल्स मोशन इज ट्रांसफर्ड टू बोथ एक्सेल्स, दैट इज इट इज ट्रांसफर्ड टू front as well as rear axle. Generally, these types of vehicles are meant for moving in rough terrain. These are termed as vehicles with four-wheel drive. The differential about which I discussed with you in previous episode is located in live axle. Generally, rear axle is live axle, but in some vehicles front axle is live axle. Accordingly, the vehicle is known as rear wheel drive or front wheel drive. As mentioned in previous episode, the live axle is in two halves. These are known as half shafts. In commercial vehicles, rear axle, which is generally live axle, is conveniently visible. You can look at it with little effort. What you look at is the axle casing. This axle casing accommodates the two half shafts and differential. The functions of casing are: number one, to act as beam and carry the load due to weight of the vehicle. This is done through suspension springs. The live axle transmits this load through dynamic loading. Dynamic loading is mainly due to A, the motion of wheel and axle assembly on ground, B, flexibility of tires and suspension system, and C, the mass of vehicle. The second function of casing is to support and accommodate the final drive, differential and half shafts. Middle portion of casing is spherical in shape. This is to accommodate the final drive and differential. Pinion and crown wheel are termed here as final drive. We have learnt in previous episode on differential that motion is transferred from propeller shaft to differential through final drive. We also know that direction of motion is changed through 90 degrees and motion is transferred to two road wheels at the end of live axle. Rotary speed is reduced as motion is transferred depending upon the diameters of pinion and crown wheel. This reduction causes increase in torque. The reductions up to 7:1 are considered small and are done in single stage gearing. As can be seen in diagram, it has a hollow casing HC. Casing being symmetrical about vertical axis, it has been shown partially in the diagram. Road wheels are mounted at the two ends of casing. As shown, the road wheel is kept in position through shoulder provided in the casing and nut N. The motion from propeller shaft is transferred to pinion shaft PS, that is integral with pinion P. The pinion P meshes with crown wheel CW. Differential cage is mounted as shown on side of crown wheel. The motion from crown wheel CW is transferred to two half shafts HS1 and HS2. The motion is transferred to road wheels connected with half shaft HS1 through cup with the help of nut N as shown. The road wheels through suspension springs support the hollow casing. I would be talking about these springs slightly later. In this diagram, these have not been included for the sake of simplicity. The casing in turn supports the weight of vehicle. It is required to be stiff enough to take up the load of vehicle. If reduction is beyond 7:1, then it is carried out in more than one stages. This is essential in case of big commercial vehicles because high torque is required to take up heavy load. If speed is being reduced in two stages, both the reduction may be provided at the center of axle. It is also possible to provide one stage of reduction at the center of axle and other stage of reduction at the road wheels. First, let us take up the two-stage reduction at the center of axle. Referring to the diagram, this is double reduction final drive. The bevel pinion PI is driven by propeller shaft. It meshes with crown wheel CW. The crown wheel CW is fixed to lay shaft LS. The lay shaft also carries spur pinion SP as shown. The lay shaft LS is supported at ends in casing through ball or roller bearings. Spur pinion SP meshes with spur wheel SW. The differential cage CA is fixed on spur wheel SW as shown in the diagram. Two half shafts HS1 and HS2 are located on left and right side as shown. This is an arrangement where both stages of reductions have been provided in the center of axle. Let us consider another arrangement where one stage of reduction is in the center of axle and the other stage of reduction is at the road wheels. Referring to the diagram, the pinion PI meshes with crown wheel CW. Cage CA can be seen on right hand side of crown wheel. Two half shafts HS1 and HS2 are on left and right hand side as shown. At the ends of half shafts, pinion P1 and P2 are mounted. These mesh with gear G1 and G2 as shown. The gears G1 and G2 have shafts as shown on which the road wheels are mounted through suitable hubs. To keep diagram simple, the hub and wheel assembly has not been shown. In this case, the half shafts rotate at higher speed than road wheels and transmit smaller torque as compared to half shafts in single stage reduction. From the diagram, it may be realized that half shafts are below the axle casing. This provides low body position to vehicle and ground clearance is reduced. For high ground clearance, the half shafts are required to be above axle casing, which is not used due to certain difficulties. This arrangement is suitable when high ground clearance is not priority. Considering the live axle arrangement, the casing supports the weight of vehicle and load acting on it. Road wheels in turn support the casing. Casing therefore acts as a beam and is subjected to the loads as shown in the diagram. It can be seen that the road wheels provide supporting force F. W is force acting downwards due to weight and load on the vehicle. The casing is required to be stiff enough to withstand the bending action. As the vehicle moves, live axle experiences torque reaction and driving thrust. Let us talk about torque reaction first. As propeller shaft rotates, torque is applied to pinion shaft. This torque is transmitted to live axle. As the rotary speed is reduced, the torque transmitted to live axle is increased. It increases in the same ratio as speed is reduced. This increased torque is transmitted to road wheels through half shafts. As per Newton's third law of motion, there is an equal and opposite reaction that tends to rotate the half shafts in opposite direction. Therefore, pinion and pinion shaft tend to swing around the crown wheel. Due to this, casing will also tend to rotate in opposite direction. Leaf springs in suspension system are used to prevent this tendency. Sometimes additional links such as radius rods are also used. In the same manner, axle casing also tends to rotate about the axis of pinion shaft in opposite direction. Since the torque transmitted by propeller shaft is of smaller magnitude, the springs in suspension system are able to prevent it comfortably. Next, let us talk about driving thrust. The tractive effort on road wheels has an equal and opposite reaction according to the Newton's third law of motion. It is in the form of inertia of mass when the vehicle is accelerating. Actually, the live axle pushes the vehicle along. Leaf springs are the means to connect the vehicle body with the axle. These are so connected that the thrust, known as driving thrust, is transmitted. Some other connecting members that may be used are thrust members and radius rods. In addition to torque reaction and driving thrust, some other forces are also transmitted from the vehicle to the road wheels and vice versa. The leaf springs, thrust member, or radius rods should be capable of taking up the following: A. The weight of the vehicle, B. Torque reaction, C. Driving thrust, D. Brake drag, and E. Lateral forces. There are various arrangements that have been put forward. Broadly, they can be classified as: number 1, arrangement with springs taking up all the forces. Number 2, arrangement where torque reaction is taken up by separate member. Number 3, arrangement where torque and thrust are taken up by separate members. And number 4, arrangements where springs take up only the weight of the vehicle. Different members take up torque, thrust, drag reactions, etc. In the next episode, I would be talking to you about drives based on these classifications. Thanks for watching the episode.